A young woman accused of killing her three friends while driving drunk learned the consequences of her action today. Bill O'Neill was in the court when Amanda Sperduti learned her fate, and here's his report.
I'm so sorry.
Amanda Sperduti apologizes to the family and friends of the three people she killed in a drunken driving accident. The 21-year-old from Winston-Salem, a graduate of Mount Tabor High School, had a blood alcohol level more than twice the legal limit. Lab results also found marijuana in her system the night of the crash.
I suffer from it every day of my life. I'm so messed up. I suffer from this every single day of my life. I will for the rest of my life.
The victim's family told the court they'll never forget what happened either. Walter Bedwell lost his 23-year-old son, Scott, in the crash. During his emotional testimony, he never took his eyes off the defendant, Amanda Sperduti.
You can still talk to your mother. You can cry with your mother. And eventually you'll laugh with your mother. I cannot. I want to hug my boy.
Sandra Rumley lost her 18-year-old granddaughter, Taylor McCaskill, in the crash.
My life has been changed forever.
The grieving grandmother told the court she'll never have grandchildren because of that accident.
And Lord, I know you can't possibly need Taylor as much as her mother and I did.
Sonia Hardy lost her 18-year-old daughter, Sasha Hoffman, in the wreck.
We had the typical mother and daughter issues, and like all teenagers and their parents, we would quarrel over simple things, and I would give anything to argue with her again.
Sperduti, who cried during all of the testimony, broke down and sobbed after hearing Hardy. Amanda Sperduti will spend the next 7 to 12 years in state prison. And I got to tell you, Wanda, the folks in the courtroom, both the victims' families as well as the Sperduti family and their family and friends, were all shocked by the sentence here. Many of them believe that it would be much shorter in its length, not the 7 to 12 years that the Wilkes County judge, Edgar Winters, had given out here today. Very surprising verdict. And the folks for the family's victims say they are very happy with that verdict or that sentence as it was handed down today.
I'm curious, Bill, was there any interaction between Sperduti's family and the victim's family?
You know, many of them shared the same benches in this very, very crowded courtroom today, Wanda. And as you might imagine, it was a very emotional day. At one time, early in the proceedings this afternoon, the judge even asked before the recess, please, I do not want to have any confrontations in the hallway between the various families. And there was none. I saw no evidence of that today. Both sides got along extremely well, despite the fact that this was as emotional a courtroom as I've ever been in.
All right. Bill O'Neill reporting live this evening. Thanks a lot, Bill.